In this session, we will look at computer arithmetic, basically addition and subtraction of signed numbers. Okay, and for that we will see some examples which I have carefully chosen to exhibit all possible cases that may arise. And while doing the addition, first of all, we will do the addition considering all the numbers in unsigned integer representation, and later on we will do the addition considering the numbers in 2's complement representation. So right now we will look at all the numbers as if they are unsigned integers, okay, 4-bit binary numbers without any sign bit. Let's add them and let's see what's going to happen. So before we start, we will look at the range of 4-bit unsigned integers. The range of n bit unsigned integers will be given by 0 to 2 to the power n minus 1. And as far as 4-bit is considered, the range will become 0 to plus 15. Okay. So what we are doing, we are adding 4-bit plus 4-bit, and we want the result to be equal to 4-bit number. Okay. So 4-bit plus 4-bit is equal to 4-bit, that is what we want. Now why so? Why 4-bit plus 4-bit equal to 4-bit? Because in computers, the actual operation of addition and subtraction will be done in arithmetic and logic unit inside the registers, and registers will be of fixed length, say 8 bit plus 8 bit equal to 8 bit. You cannot be demanding for 8 bit plus 8 bit equal to 9 bit or 10 bit. So registers are fixed in length, and therefore while doing the analysis, I am not saying that the result cannot be more than 8 bit or 4 bit in this case. Of course result can be larger than that, but while analyzing the situations, we want the result to be equal to 4-bit. So here we will restrict our analysis to 4-bit plus 4-bit equal to 4-bit, and the range is given like 0 to 15. And whenever the result becomes larger than 15, say 16, 8 plus 8 equal to 16, then it will need more than 4 bits, maybe 5 bits or something like that. Let us see what are the various cases that may happen. So we'll start adding one by one. Here 1 plus 0 will be equal to 1, 1 plus 1 will be 0 with carry 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1 will be 1 with carry 1, and 1 plus 0 will be equal to 1. And there is no fifth bit generated during the process. Now the fifth, okay, it is 1101, let's not jump directly, it is 1101. Now these are the carry bits that were generated during the process of addition. And let's see what are the values. In unsigned, 0, 1, 1, 1 means 1 plus 2 plus 4, 7, plus 1, 1, 0 means 6. Okay. And the result should come out to be equal to 13. We will verify whether it's 13 or not. Okay. Should be 13. And let's check. So 8 plus 4, 12 plus 1 comes out to be equal to 13. So what we will say, that the addition is correct. Okay. Now come to this example. 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0 is also equal to 1. Okay, 1, 0, 0, 0 is 8, plus 0, 1, 1, 1 is 7, and 8 plus 7 comes out to be equal to 15, and the value of all 1s also is equal to 15. Then here, let's add, 1 plus 0 will become equal to 1, 1 plus 1 will be 0 with carry 1. Now 1 plus 1 plus 0 will be 2, 2 means 0 with carry 1, and 1 plus 1 plus 1 means 3. In binary 3 is written as 1 1, which means 1 with carry 1. Okay. Now let us see what is going to happen in this case. See, 1 plus 1, 1 1 1 1 means 15, plus 1 0 1 0 means 10. So 15 plus 10 is equal to 25, all of us know. But if you take the value of these 4 bits, ignoring the fifth bit which has been generated, then the value comes out to be equal to 1, 0, 0, 1, which is 9. Okay. And the actual result which is expected is equal to 25. Now here you need to think little bit why it is happening like that. See, the range of 4-bit unsigned integers is 15, 0 to 15. So obviously, when the result goes beyond 15, an additional bit will be needed to represent a number larger than 15. Here the result is 25, and therefore one additional bit was needed. If you treat all these 5 bits as unsigned integer, then the value will come out to be equal to 25, because this value is 9 1001 plus 16. The place values are 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. So 9 plus 16 will come out to be equal to 25. And anyways, if you compare the difference between these two, 9 and 25, the difference comes out to be equal to 16. So please remember very well what is going to happen here. These things are very important in order to understand the further computer arithmetic that we are going to see. Lot many things are going to depend upon this concept. So please be very careful and focus. Okay. So we added 15 plus 10. The result comes out to be equal to 11001. Now, if we ignore the last bit, if we consider only the 4 bits, only the 4 bits that we want to consider, then the value comes out to be equal to 9. If we consider all the 5 bits, including the additional bit, then the value comes out to be equal to 25, and the actual result is 25, 9 is incorrect as far as 15 plus 10 is considered. Now, what's happening here? The difference between 25 and 9 is 16, and that 16 is, they differ by 16 because the one that we consider or ignore will decide the actual value. If you consider 1, 16 will be added to 9 and we will get 25. If you ignore the 1, then you will be only getting this 9, and therefore 9 plus 16 comes out to be equal to 25. Now, whenever such things happen, what things? Whenever the result is greater, whenever the actual result is greater than the range, then that particular condition will be called as overflow. Okay, so let me define overflow conceptually. In what case it is called as overflow? Okay, you need to understand the definition of overflow quite well. Whenever actual result exceeds the range, then that particular condition is called as overflow. Exceed the range means it is larger than the largest value, that will be called as overflow. And if it is smaller than the smallest value, then it will be called as underflow. So above the range will be called as overflow, below the range will be called as underflow. Either overflow or underflow, both are problems, and they need to be treated accordingly. So here what we will say, that 15 plus 10 equal to 25 is the case of overflow, because the actual result is equal to 25 and it falls outside the range of 4 bit unsigned integers. Okay, so remember very well, in this case overflow is occurring. Let's add the remaining two numbers. This is 0 plus 1 equal to 1, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. So this is 4 plus 3 equal to 7 within the range. Okay. And let's add here also. So it is 1000, that is 8, plus 1001, it is equal to 9. So 8 plus 9 equal to 17, which falls outside the range, and therefore again this particular condition will be called as overflow. Okay, so let's see what is going to happen. 0 plus 1 is 1, 0, 0 is 0, 0, 0, 0, and 1 plus 1 will be 0 with carry 1. So again, the correct result is 17, but if you treat only these 4 bits, then the value will come out to be equal to 1. Again, 1 and 17 will differ by 16, and that 16 difference is there because of the bit which is present at the place value of 16. Okay, so if you start considering the place values, this will be 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. Count this 16, value will be 17. Don't count 16, value will be 17 minus 16 equal to 1. Do not count 16, the value will be equal to 9. Count 16, the value will be 9 plus 16 equal to 25. But again, this particular condition is also called as overflow, because the actual result is 17 and it falls outside the range of 4 bit unsigned integers. So you should be very clear with the definition of overflow. Overflow has occurred or not entirely depends upon value, entirely depends upon the result. So actual value cannot be accommodated in the given range, will be called as either overflow or underflow. So what I will say, we have done 5 additions considering all the numbers in unsigned representation, 4 bit unsigned representation, and we got overflow in 2 of out of 5 cases, and in the remaining cases the result falls within the range. 13 is within the range, 15 is within the range, and 7 is also within the range. And now what I would say, if we start considering the last bit also, then say 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0 with carry 1, 1 1 1 is 1 with carry 1, 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1 with carry 0. Okay, 1 plus 0 is 1 with carry 0, no carry generated. Similarly, this will be 1, 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1 with carry 0. Okay, then 1 plus 0, 1, 1, 1, 0 with carry 1, 1, 1, 0 with carry 1, 1, 1, 1 is 1 with carry 1. Again here 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0 plus 0 is 0 with carry 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1 is 0 with carry 1. So you can see the only cases where overflow has occurred are those wherein a carry bit is generated. Okay, so the fifth bit we will call this as a carry flag or carry bit. So whenever the carry flag is set, that will indicate that an overflow has occurred, that the result is outside the range, is above the range. Now as far as unsigned representation is considered, the result will always be above the range. You cannot get a result which is below the range. So what I am trying to say, add one positive number to another positive number and you get a result which is less than 0 is not going to happen. Or to be more precise, underflow cannot occur in the addition of unsigned integers. So whenever it occurs, it will be the case of overflow. Okay, and that is why what I can say, that the overflow in case of unsigned integers can be detected with the help of carry flag. So whenever the carry flag is set, it means an overflow has occurred. So carry flag and overflow flags can be given the same treatment in unsigned representation. Be very careful what I am saying. I am saying carry flag, whenever the carry flag is set, it means overflow has occurred. Whenever overflow will occur, carry flag will be set. You do not need two separate flags for carry as well as overflow. Carry if and only if overflow, overflow if and only if carry, carry flag equal to overflow flag. No carry, no overflow, carry equal to 1, overflow equal to 1, carry flag has been set, overflow has occurred, carry flag has not been set, overflow has not occurred. So that is one thing. Okay. Be very clear. Conclusion is, overflow can be detected with the help of carry flag. Now, next step. In the next step, we will interpret all the numbers in 2's complement notation, and then we will see what is going to happen. So in the first column, we treated the numbers in unsigned representation. Here also we treated the number as unsigned representation, but now we are going to treat the same numbers as 2's complement representation, and we will focus only on 4 bits. We are not going to include 5th bit in the result. Now let us see. 0, 1, 1, 1 in 2's complement means 7. 0, 1, 1, 0 in 2's complement means 6. 2 plus 6 comes out to be equal to 1, 1, 0, 1. Okay, sorry. 7 plus 6 comes out to be equal to 1, 1, 0, 1. Now the meaning of 1, 1, 0, 1 in 2's complement is not 13, because the last bit is 1, it means it's a negative number, and the result can be given by minus 8 plus 5, which is equal to minus 3. So what I would say, you are adding two positive numbers and you are getting a negative number as answer. Okay, but why this is happening? Because we are treating A plus B is equal to C, A, B, C, all we are treating in 2's complement format. Okay, the format that we are following here is something like this. A plus B is equal to C. We have got something, we are adding it to something, and the result is C. A plus B equal to C. Treat A in 2's complement, value is 7. Treat B in 2's complement, value is 6. Treat C in 2's complement, the value is minus 3. And you know, 7 plus 6 equal to minus 3 is wrong. And why it is wrong? Because 7 plus 6 becomes 13. 13 was in the range of unsigned, but it is outside the range of 2's complement. Because as far as 4-bit 2's complement numbers are concerned, the range goes from minus 8 to plus 7. Okay, and therefore what we will say, that we are getting this incorrect result because of what is called as overflow. Okay, and why I am saying overflow, why not underflow? Because the actual result is 13, and 13 is greater than the largest value that can be represented, which is 7. So you are above the range, you are exceeding the range, and that's why this particular condition will be called as overflow. Fine. Then let's see what is going to happen here. Now 1000 in 2's complement means minus 8 plus 0, 1, 1, 1 means 7, and minus 8 plus 7 comes out to be equal to minus 1. And we know that minus 8 plus 7 is minus 1, and whatever value we are getting here, 1, 1, 1, 1, now 1, 1, 1, 1, all 1's in 2's complement means minus 1. So we are adding minus 8 plus 7, minus 1, actual result is minus 1, and what we are getting is also equal to minus 1. Fine. Any carry being generated here? No. 0 plus 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. So no carry is being generated. Here carries were generated in 2 columns. Fine. Okay. Now, okay, what I will do, we will write down this carry here. Okay, I will come to that later on. Fine. So here, the actual result is minus 1, and what we are getting is also equal to minus 1. Then, let's see what is happening here. 1, 1, 1, 1, all 1's means minus 1 plus 1, 0, 1, 0 in 2's complement means minus 8 plus 2. Minus 8 plus 2 will be minus 6. So, minus 1 plus minus 6 will be equal to minus 7. And what we are getting here is 1, 0, 0, 1. Ignore this flag. Okay, bit. Okay, we are not considering 5 bits. We are considering only 4 bits. Everywhere, while considering 2's complement, everywhere we are considering only 4 bits. So 1, 0, 0, 1 in 2's complement means minus 8 plus 1 equal to minus 7. Again, we are getting minus 7, and the actual result is also equal to minus 7. Fine. So no overflow has occurred. And let's come here now. 0, 1, 0, 0 is 4. 0, 0, 1, 1 is 3. And the result is 7. It is 7. Okay, in 2's complement, 0, 1, 0, 0 will be equal to 4. This will be equal to 3, and the result will be equal to 7. Both are positive, so they will look the same in unsigned as well as 2's complement. Here, 1, 0, 0, 0 in 2's complement means minus 1, and 1, 0, 0, 1. Sorry. 1, 0, 0, 0 in 2's complement means minus 8 plus 1, 0, 0, 1 in 2's complement means we have seen this value, yes, minus 7. And minus 8 plus minus 7 comes out to be equal to minus 15. And you can see that minus 15 goes below the range. Minus 15 is smaller than the smallest possible value that can be represented. So it is below the range, and below the range will be called as underflow. So don't call it overflow, call it underflow. Okay, and minus 15 is the correct result. Let us see what we are getting here. Here, if you treat these 4 bits, then the sign bit is plus, is 0. It means the result that we are getting will be equal to plus 1. And plus 1 is not equal to minus 15. So actual result should be equal to minus 15. But what we are getting here is equal to 1. And that's why this particular condition will be defined as underflow. Now, we need to think over this. How to identify underflow in case of 2's complement representations? Now see, what was the criteria for overflow in unsigned? Whenever the carry bit was set, we said that an overflow has occurred. Can we say the same in case of 2's complement representation? Let's see. Now, where the overflow has occurred? What I will do, I will write down both the values. Wait. What I will do? 7 plus 6, actual result is 13. But the result that we are getting here is minus 8 plus 5. Minus 3. So we are getting minus 3, actual result is 13. Here we are getting minus 1, and the actual result is also equal to minus 1. Okay, here we are getting minus 7, and the actual result is also equal to minus 7. So minus 7, minus 7. Here we are getting 7, actual result is also 7. So I will write down 7 slash 7. Okay, and here we are getting 1, but the actual result comes out to be equal to minus 15. Okay, minus 8 plus minus 7 is equal to minus 15. So what we will say, that this addition is correct one. Now how I should write? I will tick it. It's a correct one. Okay, minus 7 minus 7, it's a correct one. 7 7 is correct. 1 minus 15 is incorrect. Minus 3 13 is also incorrect. Now here, what has happened? Why it's incorrect? Actual result is 13, we are getting minus 3, incorrect. Why incorrect? Because the actual result is 13, which goes above the range, and therefore this particular condition will be called as overflow. So this is incorrect, because overflow has occurred. So I will write down this condition as overflow, and in this case 1 minus 15, again we are getting incorrect result because the correct result is minus 15. It is below the actual range which is available, and that's why this particular condition will be called as underflow. Okay, so here overflow has occurred, here underflow has occurred. Now how to identify overflow and underflow in terms of bits? Let us understand the problem first. In case of unsigned, how did we identify overflow? We say overflow will occur if the carry bit is set, if the carry flag is set. So if you get a fifth bit equal to 1, we will say overflow in case of unsigned, not in case of 2's complement. And now what do we want to do? We want to see how the overflow or underflow can be identified in terms of bit patterns, how they can be identified in terms of bit patterns. And for that, what we will do, there is one nice observation here. So for that, I have to restructure all these things. What we will do, we will write down this carry here. See, it is 1 plus 0, 1, 1, 1, 0 with carry 1, 1, 1, 1 is 1 with carry 1, and 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1 with carry 0. Okay, so instead of writing the carry down, I will write down the carry upwards, so that all the carries we can see in one line. Here also, 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0 is 1 with carry 0. Okay, so we will write down the extra carry in the fifth column, first, second, third, fourth and fifth column, upwards we will write down. Sorry. What I will do, okay, let me write down all the carries. 0 plus 1 is 1 with carry 0, 0 plus 1 is 2, means 0 with carry 1, 1 with carry 1, 1 with carry 0. Okay, so I will write down all carries now. 0 plus 1 is 1 with carry 0, 0 plus 1 is 1 with carry 0, 0 plus 0 plus 1 is 1 with carry 0, and 0 plus 1 plus 0 is 1 again with carry 0. Now here let's do the addition again. 1 plus 0 is 1 with carry 0, 1, 0 plus 1 plus 1 is 0 with carry 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0 with carry 1, and 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 1 with carry 1. So these are the carry bits generated. Let's mark them in box. Okay, here also 0 plus 1 is 1 with carry 0, 0 0 1 is 1 with carry 0, 0 1 0 is 1 with carry 0, and 0 0 0 is 0 with carry 0. Okay, and last one, 0 1 is 1 with carry 0, 0 with carry 0, 0 with carry 0, 0 1 1 is 0 with carry 1. Okay, now let's relate the overflow and underflow with the carry condition. Now you can, there is one observation here, the last two carry bits are same, here also the last two carry bits are same, and in the last example here also the last two carry bits are same. Okay, so whenever you get the correct result, the last two carry bits are always same. And what do I mean by last two carry bits? The carry bit coming in the last column and the carry bit going outside the last column. Okay, so the last two carry bits, see what this one will be called as, this one is carry in and this zero is carry out from the last column. Okay, so this one is carry out from the third column and carry in the fourth column. The carry goes out from the third column, it is generated by third column and it is written in the fourth column. The carry which is generated by the fourth column will be written in the fifth column. So the carry which goes out from column 2 will go into column 3. So column 2 carry out will be column 3 carry in. It's like that. Okay. So what we will say, that the carry in of the last column and carry out from the last column are different and you are getting incorrect result. Carry in the last column and carry out, obviously we will focus only on the last column. Okay. So carry in and carry out are same, we are getting correct result. Carry in, carry out are same, again we are getting correct result. Carry in, carry out are same, we are getting correct result. Carry in, carry out are different, we are getting incorrect result. Okay, so what does that mean? Okay, and when we say incorrect result, why the results are incorrect? Either because of overflow or because of underflow. And how to identify overflow and underflow, that also we can do. So whenever you get 0 1, okay, bit pattern 0 1, then it means an overflow has occurred. And whenever you get 1 0 as a bit pattern, it means an underflow has occurred. So whenever you add n bit numbers to n bit number, what you need to do, I will try to summarize. 1, 2, 3, 4, any number of bits you are adding, for example, what you should do, you should simply observe the carry which comes into the last column and goes out of the last column, and compare these two carry. Okay, carry in and carry out from the last column, you need to compare, and if those carries are same, you will get the correct result. Now when I say same, they may be 0, 0, they may be 1, 1, doesn't matter. But when they are different, you will be getting incorrect result. Now different, again two possibilities, either 1, 0 or 0, 1. Now whenever you get 0, 1, it means overflow, and whenever you get 1, 0, it means underflow. So whether you get correct result or incorrect result can be decided entirely on the basis of last two carry bits, not only the last carry bit. Okay, last two carry bits. See, as far as unsigned representation was concerned, you could decide the overflow only on the basis of carry out from the last column. But in 2's complement, overflow and underflow has to be decided on the basis of carry in and carry out from the last column. And the logic is quite simple. Examples are there in front of you. So you need to observe this pattern, whether the last two bits are same or not. Okay, again I am repeating, when the bits are same, it means you are getting the correct result. When the bits are different, you are getting incorrect result. Incorrect result means either underflow or overflow. Overflow can be identified by 0, 1, and underflow can be identified by 1, 0. So that's it. This is how you are going to identify overflow as well as underflow in case of addition of signed numbers. And when you add unsigned plus unsigned, there is only one possibility, which is overflow. But whenever you add signed numbers, then there are two possibilities, either you may get overflow or you may get underflow or you may get correct result. So you need to remember this. Unsigned integers, whenever you add, either you will get a correct result or you will get overflow. Here there are three cases, either correct result or overflow or underflow. Okay, so these are the examples that you should note down, think over it, work over it, try to do all the calculations, all the representations yourself. Just take the bit patterns from me, you copy all the 5 additions, do the additions yourself, write down the carry flag yourself, write down the carries yourself, compare the carry from the last column yourself, and try to draw the same pattern yourself. You need to work on this. Okay, simply by looking at the video and thinking over it won't do the job. Rather than that, take paper and pencil and work out on it. Okay, you need to work, you need to do all these things. It's mathematical in nature, and when you do it yourself once, it will be understood to you completely and forever. You will get marks on such types, and this topic is important in computer arithmetic, in digital logic, in Booth's algorithm, in signed multiplication. So wherever you see arithmetic, number representation, signed numbers, this particular concept is very important. So don't ignore it, don't underestimate it. Note down all the examples. I will give you a clear board, note it down, write it down, work on it. Next couple of videos will be based upon same thing. We are going to discuss this in more detail. We will write down all the important properties, and we will solve actual gate questions on this concept. Thanks.